Use the Oracle Autonomous Data Warehouse Cloud Console to create an instance and create a user. Log in to Oracle Cloud Infrastructure using the information from your welcome email or your cloud administrator. On the Cloud Account page, enter your cloud account name and click Next. Enter your username and password. Click Sign In. On the My Services page, click the navigation menu in the upper left to show the top-level navigation choices. From the navigation pane, click Autonomous Data Warehouse. The console for Autonomous Data Warehouse Cloud appears. You can use the List Scope drop-down menu to select a compartment. In this example, the ADWCSQA compartment is selected. Although this console shows that no data warehouses have yet been created, if there were a long list of data warehouses, you could filter the list by using the Filters drop-down menu to filter the state of the data warehouse, available, stopped, terminated, and so on. Click Create Autonomous Data Warehouse. In the Create Autonomous Data Warehouse dialog, select a compartment for the data warehouse from the drop-down list. Oracle recommends that you create this resource in a compartment other than the root. Enter a data warehouse display name for display purposes. Enter the database name. Specify the number of CPUs for your service. Select your storage capacity in terabytes, and specify an administrator password for the admin user of the service instance. For license type, select whether you are using an included license or bringing your own license. Click Create Autonomous Data Warehouse. The Create Autonomous Data Warehouse dialog closes. On the console, the State field indicates that the data warehouse is provisioning. When creation is completed, the State field changes from provisioning to available. Once you have created the instance, download the credentials zip file for client access to that instance. From the Instance Details page, click DB Connection. Download a zip file containing the security credentials and network configuration files to access your instance. You're prompted to create a password for the credentials zip file. Enter a password and click Download to download the file. Store the file and make note of the password. Some database clients require both the credentials wallet and the password to connect to the database. SQL Developer 18.2 and later does not require this password. Now you can define a SQL Developer connection to the database in your Autonomous Data Warehouse Cloud service. Click New Connection to open SQL Developer and define a connection. Specify a connection name. Enter the database username using the default administrator database account, admin, that is provided as part of the service. Enter the admin user's password that you or your cloud administrator specified when creating the service instance. For connection type, select Cloud Wallet. For the configuration file, click Browse and select the client credentials zip file downloaded from the Autonomous Data Warehouse Cloud service. For the service, select Low, Medium, or High. These service levels map to the low, medium, and high consumer groups, which provide different levels of performance and concurrency. Click Connect to connect to your database. Once you have connected SQL Developer to your Autonomous Data Warehouse Cloud database, use a SQL Developer worksheet to define database users. Autonomous Data Warehouse Cloud databases come with a predefined database role named DW role. This role provides the common privileges for a data warehouse developer. For detailed steps on performing the example shown in this video, go to the Oracle Learning Library and open the tutorial named Provisioning Autonomous Data Warehouse Cloud. Find out more at cloud.oracle.com/datawarehouse.